So right off the bat, I did not play the first Nioh, so I want to preface that as far as the story, previous mechanics, things like that. This is going to be a review of Nioh 2 strictly as a standalone game. We'll start off with the character creator itself, and I have to say I definitely was satisfied with the number of options that you have to really bring your character to life in the specific image that you have in your head. Right off the bat, you pick whether your character is male or female, which I'll always praise games for doing, because when you're able to do that and not be restricted to one or the other, it does wonders for the amount of immersion you can get out of a game. I do know, however, that this can bring about some consequences depending on how you feel about it, but it does lead to, as in many games with custom characters, your character being a silent protagonist. I for one welcome this silence if it means that I get to build my character from the ground up in the image I had in mind. There of course are many sliders for you to play around with, and pretty much anything can be repositioned or colored the way that you want. You even get to do a tiny bit of customizing the different yokai forms that you take depending on what type of guardian spirit you have equipped at the moment. This character creator gets the job done and then some. I never really found myself saying, oh, I really wish they had this, which is a sign of a solid character creator. The story in Nioh 2 is definitely not going to be the thing that you come away from and have to tell your friends or someone about. That's by no means saying that it's bad or awful, it's just not its strong suit. You can actually choose if the game is in Japanese, or you can choose to take the route and have it dubbed in English. I chose to have the game in Japanese to get that full immersion. I thoroughly enjoyed the way the story is spliced into the history of Sengoku Japan and gives you a deeper look with things like actual passages from the books on its history. It's a warring time which brings about much conflict and betrayal. You as the protagonist are part human and part yokai mercenary who is hired to slay those very same yokai. Think of Blade and how he's part vampire that hunts vampires. By the way, no Blade or Wesley Snipes slander will be tolerated in my comments, so don't even try. The cutscenes are pretty bare bones and straight to the point, so don't expect to be able to put your controller down when they come on, because they're pretty quick. It's basically set to a typical schedule throughout the game, as far as when these mini cutscenes happen too. At the beginning of a mission, right before a boss, and after a mission. I did, however, enjoy the style of the cutscenes when you come in contact with another spirit guardian. It's a straightforward story that takes some pretty sharp turns, and it's just enough to make you hang on and watch the scenes rather than skipping them, which you can actually do if story really isn't your thing in the first place. You don't really get to build much of a relationship with the characters as the protagonist, or even as yourself as the player. One character individually stole the show for me, and that happened to be Tokichiro. His mannerisms, personality, voice acting were all on point, and he's a solid character on paper from the start. As far as the main antagonist, I didn't find myself pushing through the game because I was super eager to take them down. It felt like to me you didn't get enough face time or background for you to really invest time in hating them. As much as it sounds like I dislike the story, that's not the case. Just like I said, it's not its strong suit. There were still times where it brought out emotion from me like a smile or a slight gasp. I never felt disconnected, but I didn't really find myself ever on the edge of my seat. If you're looking for the selling point of Nioh 2, you'll want to look elsewhere. There are some pretty cool informational tidbits in your hut for you to read up on and get background on story characters, yokai, and even the big bad bosses. A neat little caveat they threw in there is that you have to earn this information by letting subsequent triumphs against those enemies be the key to unlocking more information on them. Now, there are a lot of great selling points, so let's go ahead and continue. When we talk about visuals with Nioh 2, we jump to a similar sentiment as I had with the story. From a graphic sense, you're not going to be blown away, especially by today's standards, but I'm actually glad they did this, because in this case, it's very noticeable in how fluidly you move throughout the game without any lag or interruption. Nioh 2 uses the same engine as the first Nioh, and again, I'm glad they made this decision. In a game like Nioh 2, where the slightest hesitation or failure to react will see you caught in a chain of attacks, I welcome the idea of using a game engine that takes the action combat title seriously. It's a tough balance for games like these to push boundaries graphically while keeping things stable and fluid during combat. Team Ninja clearly decided to skew more towards that stability, and I commend them for doing that instead of feeling the need to reinvent the wheel for a slightly more impressive visual visual component. Now, while the graphics may not be especially groundbreaking, the actual design of the enemies and the variation of those enemies is something I absolutely give them a round of applause for. Every new enemy I came into contact with, I caught myself on many occasions saying wow in my head just at the stunning design alone, but then I left even more impressed after experiencing their mannerisms, movements, and attack sets. And not to mention the representation of the yokai in-game from their source material is an incredible feat on its own. They matched it extremely well to the source material. Even the enemies that get a bit of the recoloring treatment felt like completely and totally new enemies, despite sharing some sort of the assets. It's very hard to get bored with enemies in Nioh 2 because it's very rare that you come into repeated contact with a single enemy type in a short span, unless you're like me and die a lot. Which, let's be real, that's pretty much a given with a game like this, and we welcome that. When it comes to the designs of the bosses, you can comfortably describe them as refreshing, unique, and in a lot of cases, straight nightmare fuel. I'll never be able to look at horses the same way again. Audio can pretty much be summed up as scarce, but beautifully used in pivotal moments. First, we'll address the scarcity. Throughout your journey, throughout the various landscapes, you won't notice much in the way of audio outside of your gear rattling and your footsteps as you run. Once you get into some combat situations, that's when the music will kick in. The scores during boss fights are the ones that you'll really enjoy in the moment, but if I'm honest, I can't really think back to any of them that I need to download or go back and listen to. The main tracks that I've stuck in my head are the songs that play while you're on the world map because of how often I was there, and the song that plays during the opening cinematic because they give you 5 seconds to press any button at the beginning menu before the cinematic plays again. Where the audio really comes in strong is the combat, more specifically in its way that it helps you react. There are distinct audio cues that help you know when to counter, when an enemy has spotted you, and when an enemy is about to do an attack that you can't block and must dodge. In this game, you really cannot let the enemy get any kind of upper hand because even the lowest of the totem pole can take you out if you present an opportunity. With this being the case, you'll find yourself being on edge if something hasn't happened in a bit. Like the saying, it's quiet, too quiet, coming into fruition. Enemies can hang from trees or perch on branches, cling to ceilings or buildings ready to drop on you if you don't catch them. You'll also have enemies specifically put right around a wall or corner so you can't lock onto them and have to go out into the open knowing you need to be ready to block or dodge. A nice little handy tip for you in this regard is that getting a piece of armor that has the enemy sense trait on it does wonders. And if you're not a fan of using a trait spot for that, trust your instincts. If you hear something that sounds like the heavy breathing of an Enki, it is. Look up and snipe them out of that tree. As I stated before, this is my first experience with the Nioh series, so something that really caught me off guard was the loot. When I first took out the Nightmare Horse in the beginning mission, I could have sworn that I had Nioh 2 in my PS4, but it was clearly Borderlands because an absolute fountain of loot geysered from Secretariat as it perished. Let's be real, we all love loot, and we all love the rush we get when an abundance of it pops up. Team Ninja clearly understood this as well, but the key is that they struck a proper balance of when this happens. You don't get a flood of loot when you take out a mini Genki or an Enki or a Mankey, but when you do take out that cat with flaming wheels attached, you're rewarded handsomely for all the blood, sweat, tears, and excessive reassurance to others that you're not an angry person, the game is just really hard, and sometimes when you get so close to beating a boss after a long encounter, then get caught being too aggressive, it just makes you want to throw your controller like any other normal person. But back to the loot. There are 5 different levels of loot, with one specifically being exclusive to a new game plus mode. I can honestly say I have no qualms with the loot and the grind to obtain it, but I'll speak more on that in a later section of this review. Now we come to the absolute game-changing section in my opinion, the gameplay, mainly combat. You go through a loop on missions of fighting enemies, unlocking shortcuts and alternative routes, while resting from shrine to shrine, that act as your respawn points. As I said before in the visual section of the review, I cannot commend Team Ninja enough for the amount of fluid and polish I experienced with Nioh 2's combat. The sheer versatility you have with a weapon, and I'm not speaking in terms of the versatility between switching weapons, I'm talking about purely being able to switch stances and that how much that alone completely turns the combat and playstyle on its head. You will have different combos, different skills, and have differentiating effects on your animations, whether it be the weight or speed of your swings. For me and the lack of movement in my fingers, this switching between stances mid-combat isn't an optimal option. The good news is that with the skill trees for each weapon, you can invest heavily in one of the three stances and invest just enough into the other stances to pick up helpful passives. I'm a heavy hitting kind of guy, so being able to typically stick to the high stance with weapons and finding a way to optimally play in the stance is a fun and enjoyable experience. Even for someone like me that's limited in how well they can hit button combinations or struggle with timing. And something that I do need to talk about that I'm always going to praise games for doing because it actually seems like it's kind of a rare thing these days, but having the option to completely and totally customize your controller and the buttons that do what is fantastic, and I'm really happy that Team Ninja put it in Nioh 2. I have quite the bit of proficiency with all of the weapons except for the sword. All of these weapons range in their capabilities, and some boast heavy, damaging attacks, while others benefit from playing in a low stance because they can get more hits off in such a short span of time. That is the beauty of Nioh 2. There's almost an overwhelming amount of ways to get to the same ending point. While I can smash an opponent's guard with just a few swings of the Odachi, someone else may rattle off a monk-like flurry of blows to where if you even think about letting your guard down, you'll be met with a devastating combo. But by the time you decide whether you're going to drop your guard and attack or keep your guard up, your guard has already been broken by 900 hits the person in low stance let off. Looping back to the audio and visual components, they play a key role in combat to help you create an opportunity for yourself or even to swing things back into your favor. Another handy tip in regards to this is to work toward and take the passive bonus that restores your health when you burst counter in critical condition. It helped me to stay aggressive instead of frantically dodging and eventually getting clipped. Combat even with a single enemy will have you on your toes, but when you accidentally pull another enemy, especially the ones who sit back and shoot from range, you really get nervous and anxious, which is why I don't have a face cam when I stream because I would be like this the whole time. Boss fights are extremely intense and make you feel small no matter how perfectly you've built your character. Don't get me wrong, there's probably plenty of spammy or cheesy builds to sweep through content later on, but there was never a boss battle that I thought to myself, well, that could have been a little bit harder. That extreme feeling of accomplishment when you finally do take down that giant yokai is clearly there, and multiple times had me audibly expressing how much I hated that boss and how they were losers because I beat them after my 20th try. It would pretty much be impossible to go through all the intricacies of combat without making this video way longer than it needs to be. But the fact remains that you still make it your own. You can jack up your stamina and roll with some heavy armor, or you can keep things light and move like water around the battlefield to tire out and bring your foes to their knees. Once you've found your weapon of choice and mastered its skills, now you get to make more choices. Will you spruce things up with a bit of elemental Onmyo magic, or will you sabotage your opponent with debilitating tactics like poison and paralysis with ninjutsu? Oh, and by the way, you can totally shoot guns, hand cannons, or bows, and you can very easily build towards these things and have them be your main route of attack. They even have sets that strictly benefit those kinds of weaponry. From there, you can take on different spirit guardians. Your main spirit guardian will give you their bonuses in totality, assuming that you have the right stat requirements, while your secondary spirit will give you just one passive bonus and add a 50% clip. Now that you found out what spirit guardians you like, it's time to attune soul cores. What are soul cores? Well, you get these from time to time when you defeat enemies and are able to slot them into your spirit guardian to give you more passive bonuses and even more yokai abilities for you to use. You see what I mean about combat being almost overwhelmingly deep? Let me be clear that I mean that in the most positive way possible. We need more of this in games immediately because it's an absolute blast coming up with new approaches, playstyles, and builds. To dig a little deeper into some of those playstyles, we're going to talk about progression. Progression in Nioh 2 is extremely forward in some ways, while in other areas it's a bit more time consuming, and you might benefit from doing a little bit of research. As far as leveling goes, it's one of the straightforward aspects. You kill enemies, find items, complete missions, and even break certain things in the environment to get experience. Once you get to a certain number, you can trade in all that experience to level up and get another point to put in one of your stats. A quick tip on this is when you notice your gauge in the bottom right hand corner changes colors, that means you're ready to level up. So keep this in mind if you're nearby a shrine and don't want to risk losing all your experience on consecutive deaths. Beyond the progression of leveling, there are plenty of loot-specific goals for you to meet, but most notably are armor sets that give you a very nice boost in power depending on your style of play. In the over 160 hours I've played, I would be confident in saying that a large portion of these hours were spent theory crafting and testing out build ideas. Speaking of builds, you aren't locked into anything at all in Nioh 2. Books of Reincarnation are available for you to reset your stats at any time, though it does progressively get more expensive with each use. Your skill trees operate in the same sense, but only require a fee of gold rather than a specific item. I know for myself I used 2 in my first playthrough and did not feel hindered or a step behind in any way afterwards. Speaking of that first run through, Nioh 2 offers up a new game plus, which introduces a new level of gear and ups the difficulty while also upping the quality of loot drop. It also sees the forge system get some new intricacies that will see your power grow as well. As far as the grind to work your way up the progression path, I've thoroughly enjoyed it and haven't found it to be too tiring yet, thanks to that on your toes punishing combat. But let's be honest, at some point, all grinds must come to an end, and you find yourself a little bit burnt out. The very bright note on this is that I do not see that light at the end of the tunnel coming anytime soon for me. There truly is so much more that you could talk about with Nioh 2 if you dove into all the hidden intricacies. I myself have thoroughly enjoyed my time in the world of yokai, so much so that I was supposed to do a playthrough of the base game, but got sucked in so quick that before I knew it, I had beaten the game and will now be doing a playthrough of New Game Plus instead. So come back for that if you feel so inclined. The graphics and audio of this game aren't going to blow you away, but they are absolutely solid and used specifically for the betterment of the game overall and the core components that mean the most. They implement these into a combat system that is incredibly satisfying and has an unbelievable amount of flexibility for each player to make combat their own. Knowing when to burst counter or dodge out of an area completely is covered thoroughly with audio and visual cues. Whether you decide to move fluidly and quick with the sword or decide to bring the punishment with the axe, you never feel like you're pigeonholed into playing a specific way when you face an enemy. Yes, there are optimal approaches, but no matter the situation, if you learn to master your choice of playstyle, you're always rewarded. If you've never played an RPG before, the amount of sheer choice you have might have you a little flustered or overwhelmed, but if you've been in the RPG scene already, you'll be salivating at the amount of flexibility you have with your character. I came to Nioh 2 for that very specific reason, and I've been in no way disappointed with it or found myself asking for more. They even hide certain skills entirely from skill trees that are already impressive in size and give you a good reason to try out weapons you may not have gravitated to at first. The gameplay is incredible, combat is punishing but fair, rewarding but nerve-wracking, boss fights feel intense and bring a strong feeling of accomplishment and triumph, although I will say on one boss, they pull the, oh, you thought you beat me but I'm back up again trope, which kind of felt forced. Loot is never a thing you feel shorted on, and it's been quite balanced in my opinion. All in all, I could rage about Nioh 2 all day and all night, but I simply could sum up that ranting and raving into a simple phrase of game of the year, so far, and I would not be at all shocked if that holds true clear through the end of 2020. But that's going to be it for this one. If you liked the video, please do let me know with a thumbs up. Comment your thoughts on Nioh 2, and if there's something you feel people would benefit from knowing in their decision on whether or not to buy the game, drop that as well. Subscribe if you haven't already for more Nioh 2 and other gaming content. I'll be doing a playthrough of New Game Plus and would love for you to join along in the journey. Have a good night, and I'll see you in the next video.